Tony Abbott has been slammed for comments he made following BHP's decision to shelve its $30 billion Olympic Dam project. Political reporter Amanda Hart joins us now live from Parliament House in Canberra. Amanda, he's blaming the carbon and mining taxes straight up.
Yeah, Ron, Tony Abbott has been campaigning against the carbon and mining taxes as soon as they were announced, so I guess it's really little surprise that, again, he's pointing to these taxes for one of the reasons why this project isn't going ahead. Now, this would have been the biggest open-cut mine in the world, creating around about 25,000 direct or indirect jobs. BHP says it's not going ahead because of falling commodity prices and rising development costs. So Tony Abbott was asked about this, saying, why are you blaming the taxes for this when BHP says that's not the case? And he says that he hadn't read the statements. This has caused quite a stir in the government.
This is just another dishonest fear campaign from Tony Abbott, demonstrating how relentlessly negative he is. What he's asking Australians to do is to do what he did. Don't read the statement.
Now, the opposition is sticking to its argument, saying that these taxes are causing an uncertain economic environment, not just for BHP, but for all investors.
BHP, they're like diplomats. I mean, in the end, everybody speaks in code.
When you look at somebody you're about to do business with, the Australian government, and their business partner, the Greens, is arguing that the mad tax is not mad enough, don't tell me that's not a motivation about how you act.
Now, the Greens are saying that the mining tax should be increased.
Amanda, we've had a lot of concern about the whole resources boom running out of steam. Some controversial comments from the resources minister about the boom today.
Yeah, Ron, Martin Ferguson took to the airwaves saying that the end of this project, or the shelving of this project, signals that the mining boom is over. Now, he says we've done very well out of it so far. We're the envy of the world, but the last 6 to 12 months have indeed been very difficult. Penny Wong was quick to clear this up, though, saying that he meant it was a decline in the terms of trade, of course, lowering commodity prices, and we actually have a long investment pipeline ahead of us of $500 billion.
Amanda Hart, live from Parliament House in Canberra. Thank you.